and you move it around a bit, it may take you somewhere. So to me, collage is like the unexpected put together to perhaps suggest something that you never thought of. Our experience actually gives us a distance and gives us this wonderful freedom, which is called time. I thought time was running out, but it's not. Time is actually being more condensed because we are more focused. Now, our job as artists is to show you the world that you think you know and celebrate it. In my wonderful experience and wonderful journey with a person called Wong Kar-wai, that finally, after all the films we made a film called In the Mood for Love. I think everything we did before then was preparation. I think that's it. If you find this in your life, you actually say one sentence, or you make one dish, or you make one image that is true, that's pretty good, because not many people get that.
I've never卖过几多把遮，一日。但系咧整遮咧，平均嚟计咧，一日计最少都十几把嘅。望下先吓。嗱，佢呢度咧就冇坏到嘅呢段，呢个就系呢度，呢度有个掣喺呢个圆圈嘅底下，佢损毁咗。 我细路仔应该开始噶啦嘛，屋企系做呢啲噶嘛，都几多人整噶。因为点解咧？佢把遮可能系拍拖啊、生日礼物啊，总之系有啲感情嘅。阿罗姐好啊，贵姓啊？嗱，我哋开遮咧，记得红系直遮咧。原因系因为咧落过雨之后咧，记得唔好拧遮喎。 揿住个掣，震震下，震震下，记得唔好拧啊！我哋咧全程咧就记住，执好啲布先，就唔好好似垃圾咁揦一抹，啪啪啪啪啪啪啪啪啪，咁就接得好靓噶啦！教人哋揈下揈下咧，其实系错噶，令到呢骨全部歪晒噶。佢啊，但系有啲就好难整嘅。 要成个钟头整到嘅。嗱，我有个原则，如果超过三个钟先整到嘅咧，我就唔整嘅。嗱，而家呢把遮整好啦，啊，整好啦，咁啊好开心啦。The
love of money and shiny new things is slowly but surely erasing the past. So before it's gone, this is a reminder of how Hong Kong used to eat at Dai Pai Dong's, like this one in Sham Shui Po. Cheap, delicious food served from open air stalls. Pull up a plastic stool, crack a beer, fire up the wok.
So tell me, what is a Dai Pai Dong?
Dai is big.
Big.
Pie is license and dong is place. So, it's a big license place.
Right. And how many of these are left in
28.
Whoa. Only 28.
Only 28.
Why? Why don't they?
Because the government doesn't still want the street clean.
That ain't right.
Yeah.
The name of the place is Kung Ki, and Gaza Cheng recently took over as chef.
How do you get one of the last licenses for a Dai Pai Dong?
Accident.
Accident.
Yeah. This license is held by somebody else, not by me. But this place It's been around for 40 years.
Now, you change the menu, same?
Yeah, I changed the menu, right, and then start the typical old-fashioned Chinese meal.
Drunken chicken, hacked up birds cooked in hot pot with medicinal roots and herbs that will no doubt make me strong.
What will I feel after I eat it?
Hyper. I can use
hyper?
Hyper.
Energy? Strength?
Yeah, energy.
Vitality? No penis in there?
No.
No penis in there?
I wouldn't eat that myself.
Really?
Unless you want.
I've had a fair amount of penis on this show.
Oh.
A clay pot dish of fish tripes cooked in an egg custard topped with a crispy fried yuzhou.
Wait, is that egg?
Egg.
So it's like a quiche?
Try it.
It's pretty damn good. Crispy, custardy. I've never had anything like this anywhere in China. Movies?
Oh, yes. You know Wong Kar Wai?
I do.
Do you like it?
I love Wong Kar Wai. Which is your favorite Wong Kar Wai film?
Oh, In the Mood of Love.
Yeah, me too. It's the most beautiful film ever made.
You are.
No way.
It's a mixed culture with East and West.
Right.
Because after 160 years as a British colony, Hong Kong already developed its own unique culture. The people in Hong Kong really want to see that. Or for the foreign people like you, you want to see, yeah, oh, it's really old Hong Kong.
All this is disappearing. All this could be gone. It's vanishing before our eyes. Simon Goh is a photographer who's documented 200 small family-run shops in the city, many of them already shuttered.
I go everywhere in Hong Kong, and I really want to preserve some memories. Especially in these few years, I find so many old shops disappearing because of some urban development. And I think I got a mission to preserve that.
To feel sentimental about the past is unusual for Hong Kong. Hong Kong has always been about changing.
Yes.
It's always embraced change. Realistically, can these businesses be protected?
It's really difficult to say. But I think that when the government and the Hong Kong people see more about our own unique culture, so many people try their best to fight for that.
China Cafe in Mong Kok, what's called a Cha Chan Teng, or tea restaurant, serving a particularly bizarro but much-loved bit of Hong Kong history. Simon's been coming here for over 40 years and orders his favorite, fried pork cutlet over rice with tomato sauce.
Oh, thank you. Wow. This one is very popular in Hong Kong.
Very popular.
Especially schoolboy, every time I came to Cha Chan Teng, I ordered this. I think it's a perfect match for me.
And well, I had to try this. Macaroni, spam, and egg soup.
I have no idea where this came from. I mean, is it a soup? Is it a stew? Should I break it up?
No, it's okay. Because in Cha Chan Teng, nobody care about the table manner or anything, you know? You know, food and smell always recall so many memories. I still remember my parents and my grandparents, they will make some dumpling at home. And they really work hard for prepare the meal for the family. The taste is really great and really sweet. And after my grandmother and my mother passed away, I have low any chance to eat that again. But about 4 or 5 years ago, my auntie made that for me. When I put it to my mouth, I burst into tears. My wife behind comforted me. Speechless, the taste, the food, because so many memories for me.